from the beater. High kick from Silva. Now they go to ground.
Beautifully done. Caught the leg kick, rolled into the takedown. Silva's on top.
Let's see if indeed Naito starts stronger, faster, more aggressive than he did last time out. Nice curling overhand right to an inside thigh kick from Naito. Said he'd worked on his striking. Now let's see if he's learned how to check the leg kicks. They did the damage last time, Mitch.
First strike Silva landed was just that. It was a leg kick, but Naito looks to be pushing forward. He's throwing, he's creating movement. Jab landed there from Naito.
Naito jab to body shot. Double jab from the Brazilian champion. Naito edges forward, looks for a double leg. Couldn't get the takedown. Good defense there from Silva. Drives Silva against the cage now.
Interesting, Naito initiates a grapple up against the side of the cage. You can see Silva's trying to split the legs. Look for Naito to change levels or possibly go for a knee tap. But Silva's got good takedown defense. Yep, goes after the leg. Silva defends easily.
What are the options here for Silva, Mitch?
First of all, he's got to break away. That's the first exchange that he's got to do. Now he's going back to the striking.
Let's see the leg kicks from Silva. They played such a role last time out. Absolutely minced the lead leg of Naito to win the world title. Fakes an overhand right. Hooks off both hands there from Silva. But Naito looking calm at the moment, looking very relaxed and focused.
He is kind of shifting his head. You can see him dip his head off to the side of every single time that he's throwing strikes. And it puts him in a bad spot. If Silva can pick up on that encounter with something and time it just right, he could get the knockout that he told me backstage that he really wants.
Silva looking in fantastic physical condition. As always, Little Rock. Sticks out the jab, almost catches that kicking leg. Good roundhouse kick to the lower right ribs there from Little Rock. Lazy takedown attempt there from Naito, Mitch.
But he initiates the clinch, and that's where he won it. Nice.
Now he gets top position. Let's see what happens from here.
Beautiful redirection with a nice little outside trip to get Silva to the ground. But Silva is beautifully done off his back. Watch it. He's got the underhook on the right side. He's got the butterfly hooks it. Actually, no, he's got a half guard. Kind of a little bit of both. A little bit of butterfly half, maybe.
What can Naito affect from top position? Certainly a more aggressive start to this contest than we saw in their first match.
First he's got to clear these legs, which is going to be tough to do. Silva's got a really good guard. Now Silva's got the butterfly hooks in. Look for him to elevate the hips, create a little bit of space, pop right back up. Good pressure from Naito, though. Look how he's controlling the hand. Silva's trying to get a support going on in the left hand, but Naito's controlling the wrist.
Naito still from top position, showing aggression. Silva forced to defend from off of his back.
Silva's elevating the hips there. He's trying to reach under for the legs, possibly going for set up a leg lock, maybe. But Naito's got heavy hips, not allowing Silva to elevate his hips up.
If you're in the corner of Silva, what are you telling him to do here, Mitch?
Well, I mean, he's got a few options at this point. He's got the overhook on the right side, so he could butterfly sweep off to one, off to the left here like he's trying to do. But for Silva, he might just want to pop back up or at least create a little bit of scramble. Because you can see Naito, he's trying to suck the legs and he's going to try to step over that right leg there. And every time Silva posts the hand here, now he's going to start pushing down on the head and create a little bit of space because you can see Naito's trying to lace up his legs.
Is this the strategy you expected from Naito this early in the bout?
This is what he was trying to do in the first match, but Silva was stopping a lot of the takedowns and he was popping back up because he wanted to strike. But Silva's now looking for a Kimura on the far side, looking possibly to transit, but Naito's got a little bit of a leg there, so Silva can't get any leverage off that Kimura, but he's got a Kimura lock there.
Knees to the side of the face there from Alex Silva. Still trying to lock on the Kimura. 10 seconds remaining. First round. Good round of feel for Yoshitaka Naito to have begun with. Corking knees there from Naito, staying busy, and we go to the tower. Outside leg kick from Silva. Only got off a couple of them in the first round. Naito still hasn't shown the leg kicks yet.
Naito's pushing forward though.
Good jab there from Silva. Oh, there's a leg kick from Naito. Said he worked on his own leg kicks and countering off the leg kicks of Silva.
You can see how he's dipping his head off to the left there, right into the power side of Silva at that leg kick.
Naito's not checking these leg kicks, Mitch.
Yeah, but he's being more aggressive, so they're not really, you know, they're not having the same kind of impact that they were in their first matchup. He's being a lot more, he's pushing forward, and so Silva's throwing these kicks, not with that step forward like power that he had last time. He's almost stepping off the back foot and throwing that leg kick.
Silva shoots in for a double leg, switches to a single. Can he get the takedown on Naito? Walks him back against the cage. Indeed, hops him back. Looks for a double leg again.
Good defense by Naito. Pushes the head down. Silva went for the leg, and he was able to scoop the hand off of his ankle. Now Silva's got a single leg. Good balance shown by Naito so far. Look how he's fighting those hips. Look how he switches the legs. As Silva was trying to grab a hip, he was constantly changing his legs to get a better base.
We are seeing a very good grappling contest. One in which Naito seemed to be in control in the first round until the final 20 seconds or so when Silva tried to lock on a Kimura.
Oh, nice whizzer. Look at that whizzer from Naito. He's got the overhook on the left side, and he was able to kind of shrug off Silva and get back up to his feet.
What do you say Silva doing from this position, Mick?
Silva might be trying, right now he has his right hand around the hip here, and he's trying to soften him back up. But good job by Naito to get back up. He's using that whizzer very effectively to control the position. You can see now that Silva was trying to attack the leg like he did right there. But good job by Naito to use that overhook, that whizzer control, and drive Silva down to the mat and end up on top.
Mitch, how much of a different Nobita are we seeing to what we saw last time?
This is a much different athlete we're seeing right now. He's a lot more aggressive. He was able to stop the takedown. You can see that Silva initiated the grapple, but good defense by Naito. Almost thinking that maybe we're not seeing the same Silva that we saw in the first one, rather than a different Naito. I think it's both, actually. It's a different Naito and it's a different Silva, but we're still early in the second round.
Silva may be looking for a way back to his feet, posts up on that left arm.
Now Silva's the one with the overhook and the wizard. Let's see if he can be as effective as Naito was, but look for Naito to change directions and put Silva on his back, possibly. Or he might shrug and try to take his back.
Mitch, talk us through the whizzer. Explain the logistics of the whizzer and how it works.
See that right arm, how it's laced over the arm of Naito? And he uses it really well to control. You have a good control of your opponent by driving your shoulder into their arm. And now Naito is trapped in a leg entanglement here. Good job by Naito to get out of that. But that's what that whizzer is. It's the overhook on the arm, and then you're using your shoulder to control your opponent.
Alex Silva hunting after the legs, the knees now of Yoshitaka Naito. Silva top position, rolls through. Still top position for the Brazilian.
Good elevation here with the butterfly hooks. So he has his feet inside the thighs of Silva, and he's able to elevate the hips and create movement from Alex Silva. But now Silva's got that body lock.
Back to their feet now, chance for the knees. Naito throws a knee to the midsection, looks to hook the leg of Silva. Corking knee again from Nobita.
You see him trying to get Alex Silva's hips away from the back. See, there's the wizard with a good roll from Silva to end up in the top position. Very important in this very close round here. But Naito is moving forward.
Very appreciative crowd here in Indonesia. Sellout crowd in Jakarta, loving every moment of this martial arts contest for the World Strawweight Championship. Nobita peppering with the right hand.
I like how he's taking away the support arm of Silva as he's trying to create base of support. Now Silva's got the arm a little bit further away. He's got one hook in. He's trying to get Silva's back away from the fence so he can get around it. But Silva's doing a good job of keeping his back pressed up against the cage so Naito can't take his back. But Naito dives and rolls. That's some good grappling from both these guys.
He says he's his. He believes he solved the riddle of Alex Silva. Let's see how it eventuates here in the third round. Big right hand from Nobita. Hooking punches from the Japanese challenger. Thrusts out the jab. Oh, he catches Silva on the jaw. Just not enough power behind it. But this is an aggressive start to the round from Nobita. High kick from Silva. Now they go to the ground.
Beautifully done. Caught the leg kick, rolled into the takedown. Silva's on top. This is an important scramble. Who's going to win this is going to tell us a lot. Nobita's trying to slide underneath. Nobita is actually Naito's nickname. Change before look possible. Leg lock here coming from Silva. He's looking for the leg, but you can see Naito's got his leg, his foot underneath the leg of Silva, so Silva can't quite extend into a possible knee bar or reverse Ashigarami maybe. Silva's trying to stand back up. Good takedown. Look at that persistence from the former champion.
This is nothing like the Naito we saw last time, Mitch. It's a completely different animal tonight.
See, this is where Naito kind of gains the small advantages. He's moving forward with a lot of these exchanges. He's ended up on top in the scrambles.
Naito looking to establish his dominance in the grappling. Little Rock, who had so much dominance standing up with the leg kicks last time, not able to affect them in this bout thus far.
But the first time, I think Naito accepted the match on very short notice.
3 weeks. 3 weeks preparation for Naito last time, a long training camp for this one. And we are seeing the difference. He is reaping the rewards of that long camp.
He had almost three times as much time to prepare for this matchup, and we're seeing it. He's gonna take the back of a world champion at Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Look how he's controlling the legs there. He's got the legs grapevined in to prevent Silva from going anywhere. He's got one arm trapped. He chooses to let that go. Silva's rolling for a leg lock.
Silva told us that he feels that Naito played all his cards, showed his whole hand last time, and there was nothing that could concern him tonight. Do you think Silva's a little surprised by what he's seen from Nobita tonight?
I think he's very surprised. I'm very surprised to see these exchanges happening. This is a very intricate little game these guys are playing. Look here, Naito's got the back, but Silva's threatening the leg lock. So in the judges' eyes, where is this, who's getting the advantage in these exchanges? You know, the judges don't have the advantage that we do of these multiple camera angles.
All tied up like a ball of twine. 2 minutes remaining in the third round of five. It's been an impressive outing so far for Yoshitaka Naito, the former champion.
Good job from Silva. Look for him to spin to take the back, but Naito is very, very aggressive and is hunting for that single leg takedown. Now he's got the leg. He goes back up to the hips. Sweep, yo, almost swept out the support leg there.
Do you sense any frustration coming in from the champion, Mitch?
Uchimata, just like that, used it to roll, but Naito was so tight. I don't necessarily see the frustration yet because Silva's very comfortable in this position. So he's okay to be here and to look for submissions. That's the beauty of jiu-jitsu. It's just a complex game of human chess where one move creates another move. And we're seeing that just now. But look at the way Naito is controlling that leg, not allowing Silva to advance. Silva rolled for a leg, but he gave up a bad position to process.
This crowd responding as Nobita applies the action on Alex Silva. A knee there from Nobita. And back to their feet. A chance for Naito to throw more knees from this position now. Is Silva's face exposed to the right knee? What was he looking to do?
He was trying to reach under and change position, but the grip. He was trying to slide under and kind of go underneath and end up pop out the other side, but Naito's got a good squeeze to stop Silva from popping out like that.
Wrist control there from Alex Silva. Pops around, loops the left hand. We're in the final 10 seconds of this round. We are going to deep water. But both men know what that's all about. Okay, let's play at this stage last time. He's got to use those leg kicks. But the movement of Naito, so different to last time out. So much more mobility from the Japanese challenger. Not just being a stagnant target for those leg kicks. Glancing right hand from Silva. Here's a bit more mustard from the Brazilian. Now he's finding the home with his strikes.
See, but Naito's constantly putting that jab in his face, and he wants to grapple with the BJJ world champion. You can see the reddening of his leg, very similar to last time. It's not quite as blue as it was at this point in the match of their first time. But look at the way he's sucking in the legs. He's consistently trapping that leg, and that really limits a lot of what Silva can do.
Where does Silva go from this position?
Well, he's got the Kimura grip, so he's kind of just holding him there. He's got to try to get his leg out from the middle of Naito's legs right there. So that's kind of limiting a lot of where he can go. He's got the Kimura on the left arm, so you can see that grip that he's got. So there's a shoulder lock there. But without that leg in position, it's really hard for him because he could sweep. He could use that grip to kind of change the position and throw up. Naito straightened his arm out and he lost that grip. Now Naito's keeping it nice and tight, lacing the leg, going with the outside trip. Look for him to spin to the back. He tried, but Silva defended nicely. He's going with the trip again, turns the same way, and he puts Silva down on the match. That counts as a takedown. That's going to score.
I'm going to say, Mitch, after we spoke to Alex Silva a couple of days ago, this is not the style of match that Alex Silva was expecting tonight. I think Silva thought he would have his way again with Naito in the stand-up. That's what he planned to do, was simply to kick him, move around, kick the legs, outpoint him that way, and eventually finish him. This is not the style of match that Silva was expecting.
I don't think anybody was expecting this type of match, this type of grinding, grappling style, to see Naito not really dominating, but winning a lot of the scrambles, ending up in top position, just like this, landing a little bit of ground and pound. Silva's got to be more explosive. He's got to create movement. He's got to throw Naito up, get back up to his feet, because he's not winning these grappling exchanges. But don't put it past him, because he's a BJJ world champion with a third-degree black belt. So look for him. He's been there many, many times. Now he's going back to that Kimura. But again, his leg is in the same half-guard position there, and it's hard for him to really get any sort of leverage out of it.
Alex Silva, downward elbow. Can he break off, get some distance, invite Naito back to the feet and work the leg kicks? But no, Naito puts him back down on the canvas. Fabulous work here from the challenger, the former champion, Yoshitaka Naito.
Man, I've been on the mat with Alex Silva. I know how strong he is in grappling exchanges. So I can only kind of speculate how strong Naito is to be able to be holding on to him like this. Now you can see he's got one leg laced. He's got the over-under, kind of a seatbelt position there on Silva's back. Now he's got the back. Silva's turning into him.
This really is a masterclass of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. You are seeing BJJ of the highest order here, Mitch.
From your point of view, Michael, who do you think's winning? Who do you think's teaching the masterclass?
I think Yoshitaka Naito from the last set, but Alex Silva submission attempt now.
He's got the heel hook, but he didn't quite have legs in the right position to lock it in.
As being in more control, but there are those flashes of Silva going for the submission with his shoulder.
Naito's not in the fourth round.
Silva goes for the Kimura, goes for the heel hook. Those flashes from Silva keep it really interesting from the champion.
But he's going after the submission without really having the proper position. And you have to make sure when you go for the leg locks, you gotta make sure you have everything in the exact position, otherwise they're gonna pop right out of it.
But on the ground, Mitch, does that qualify as more aggression on the scoring? Should you try and slap on those submissions rather than the aggression of Naito is not trying to slap on the submissions?
30 seconds left in the fourth round.
It might count slightly in the aggression category, but it's more out of desperation, because I think Alex Silva kind of sees the opening, like here with the Kimura, the judges aren't going to count that as a near submission. It's not really locked in. He's not extended. He doesn't have the legs trapped correctly, and he's not torquing on the heel the correct way. So he's not really, I mean, he's attempting the submission. It's like attempting a punch and not really landing it, but you attempted the punch. Does it really count as aggression? Not really.
Silva comes out right hand from Nabita.
That leg kick. Silva's marching forward, throwing big haymakers, but immediately Naito shoots in for the single. Look for him to change direction and get down. Yep, just like that. But that was kind of a sacrifice throw. There's that Kimura again. The Kimura grip, but you can see Naito's got his hands laced together, but he's also got that leg locked up in between his legs, so it's hard for Silva to really advance the position or really take the next step in securing this submission. You can see Silva trying to kick the hand free. So he was trying to break Naito's grip with his foot. But Naito's just so tight. He's doing, you see again, you see how he laces the leg. And that kind of limits, Silva might roll here for the arm for the Kimura.
Mitch, let's break it down a little. If you're in the corner of Alex Silva, what are you telling him to do in this fifth and final round?
Well, first of all, he's got to try to break the grip. So that's what he's trying to do. So he's going after this Kimura here, and he's trying to advance his position. But he's got that leg right there, and he's trying to pop out the leg. But Naito, look how he scrambles. He's going to look for the leg again. Oh, Silva turns him around, takes his leg.
What will Silva look to do with this right leg, Mitch?
It depends. He might fall into the leg attack. That seems to be what he's going after a lot. Or he might just try to stand back up and get it back up to striking, which is what he does.
Overhand right there from Naito, the champion, showing his strength. There's a big thumping leg kick from Alex Silva. Howard love to land a lot more of those. Naito thrusts out a jab. Can he find another way to take the champion down? Put Silva on his back. He shoots in for a single. Hops back towards the cage. Back towards the fence they go.
He's got that single leg. He's got a high crotch now. He's going to look for the trip. Turn him around. Try to suck out the other leg. Drag Silva down. Back to the Kimura. Deja vu. We've seen this at least 7 times so far in this 5-round battle. But Silva's ending up on top now with a guillotine. Looks like he's got a one-arm guillotine. He might be trying to lace it in there. No, he chooses to step over.
Oh, Nobita. Back up to his feet. Silva, look for the right wrist.
He's always trying to suck in that leg. He's trying to control the leg, suck it in, trap it, so it limits Silva's options. Grinding on him, just
you know what I love as well, Mitch? We've got a sellout crowd here in Jakarta, and they are so appreciative of a great grappling contest like this. A highly educated martial arts crowd in Jakarta.
Very true, Michael. He's got the Uchimata again. He's got the overhook on one side. He's got the leg in between, trying to go for the throw. But Knight was like, he's just attached to him. He doesn't give Silva any room to really do anything. He's consistently grinding and wearing on Silva. He's got the overhook. He's got the leg in between. Uchimata versus outside trip. Who's going to get it?
Is it enough to be putting down points on the judges' scorecards, though, for Naito?
I mean, these are takedown attempts. It shows grappling superiority, maybe. Look at him. He's kind of taking Silva where he wants him to go. He's not necessarily doing any big takedowns. He's not trying to, you know, get double legs. He's not trying to take him for big rides or high crotches or anything like that. He's just trying to take that leg, trip him, scramble, trap the leg. End up in side control now. Silva's going to stand back up or try. Naito transitions to the back.
Oh, Naito looking to take the back of the champion. Can he get there? The challenger from Japan.
He's got one hook in now. He's got a minute left to work. He can jump on the back, get that other hook in.
This crowd wants to see both men bring it home strongly. The final 50 seconds. Who will be the strawweight champion? Will Silva defend, or will Naito take it back? Chance go up for Nobita here in Jakarta. It looks like Yoshitaka Naito winning over the crowd here in Jakarta tonight.
30 seconds left in the final
round. Alex is trying to create some movement. He tried to roll through, but Naito is just stuck on him. You just can't shake him off. He's trying to pry out the leg, trying to look for a knee bar, but Naito's just got such a tight grip. He's, look at that, he's constantly tangling up the arms, constantly attacking the legs, constantly holding on to something. Just one minor step ahead of the champion.
As the final 10 seconds roll through there from Silva, a final submission attempt from Yoshitaka Naito. And once again, in this thrilling rivalry, we've gone the distance.
New one Strawweight World Champion, Yoshitaka Naito!
Unbelievable! Yoshitaka Naito!